soon be entering ZGR's atmosphere.
The bounty for this mission does not seem appropriate. The risk clearly outweighs the reward.
Entering the atmosphere in T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That elevator leads to the depths of an underground facility. Signal quality is likely to be low. Remote communication remains a problem. Try to connect to the facility's network when you reach the bottom. That way, take pain in contact. Many objections, lady.
Loading data.
So, you've accessed the network station. Well done, Samus. I have reviewed your vital signs and video log from the data you uploaded. I've run a full analysis, but I cannot account for why you lost consciousness. My readings indicate dramatic physical changes in you. Whatever caused these changes seems to have stripped you of most abilities. You might call it physical amnesia. That brings me to your assailant. I am checking the Federation database against your video log. It appears to have been a Chozo. The attacker's identity is not yet clear. I have determined that you are somewhere within the depths of ZDR. Your top priority should be to return to your ship on the surface. This situation is precarious. Trust your instincts as you navigate upward. This planet appears to consist of multiple areas, shuttles, elevators, and other modes of transport connect them. Keep an eye out for ways to reach the surface. The ship's location is marked on your global map. Check it for yourself. You may encounter pockets of low temperature. Your Metroid DNA renders you vulnerable to such environments. Spending time in cold areas will be harmful to you. There are many such cold areas scattered underground. Do not enter them with your basic power suit. One final thing. Underground interference is preventing radio transmissions. Check in with me at any network stations you find.
Uploading data.
Both enemy you encountered were clearly trying to capture you. They may have been hacked. If so, it's reasonable to assume all enemy will be hostile. Emmy, send out a pulse to detect vibrations in the air within a certain range. Essentially, they can hear you. Upon detecting vibrations, an Emmy enters surveillance mode to track their source. Stay out of its line of sight when this happens. Otherwise, the danger to you increases dramatically. An Emmy that has seen you will begin pursuit. Part of the pursuit protocol is to seal the Emmy zone exits. You will be trapped inside. To survive, you must leave its range of pursuit. Evade the Emmy and it will disengage. This will also unseal the exits. An Emmy never leaves its assigned zone. Their control system must permit them to operate only within that range. I estimate a 99% probability of death if an Emmy captures you. There may be a very small opportunity to escape, but exploiting this window will be virtually impossible. The Emmy are immune to your current weapons. You lack the unique energy used to defeat the first Emmy. Your only option now is to evade capture and find an exit. Your highest priority in an Emmy zone should be simply to survive.
Thank you.
Uploading data.
There is no record of your assailant in the Federation database. However, there are records of a Chozo warrior tribe. There is a strong possibility that you are connected. You have seen the warrior tribe's architecture and artifacts on this planet. I conclude that this was one of their settlements. But why would someone lead you here and send the Emmy after you? The footage of the ex-parasite may have been staged to lure you in. The situation remains unclear. But your priority hasn't changed. You must return to the ship. You have activated the Magna Supply system that has restored power to the closed thermal doors. Seek them out to proceed. Continue to search for the unique energy you employed against the first Emmy. It is the only way you can confront them. Unfortunately, this energy is limited. You may have noticed it dissipating after an Emmy is destroyed. There are 6 remaining Emmy hunting you. You have no means to confront them. Remember that.